to story time. Now, with the festival of Mahashivratri approaching, let us hear a series of stories on the great Lord Shiva. And today's story is about his consort, goddess Sati. Sati was the daughter of Daksh, who was a Prajapati. He was one of the Manasputra or mind-born sons of Lord Brahma. Sati was very virtuous, intelligent, beautiful, and devoted to Lord Shiva, while Daksh was vain, pompous, and arrogant of his power and position. However, as Sati had set her heart on marrying the Lord, Daksh unwillingly gave his consent, and Sati left happily and began residing in the abode of Kailas with Lord Shiva. Meanwhile, Daksh decided to hold a huge sacrifice or yagna in which guests were called from all the three worlds. There were devatas, rishis, and such other esteemed guests. Preparations were afoot. The priests had begun singing mantras and hymns. There were beautiful pots filled with sacrificial offerings. The hall was decked with flowers. And at that time, Daksh entered. Seeing the host of the yagna enter, everybody in the assembly hall stood up to respect him and honor him. However, there were two who were still seated. And those were Lord Brahma, because he was Daksh's father and he needed get up when his son enters the hall, while the other was Lord Shiva. Now, Lord Shiva is far, far superior to any other being on earth, and it would be a sin if he prostrated to Daksha, and Daksha would have had to suffer for this sin. And so Lord Shiva remained seated in his yogic meditation. Daksha, however, took it as an insult and started raging, and then started hurling abuses on Lord Shiva. He told him, "You insolent person, don't you have any manners? You do not know the difference between purity and impurity, respect and disrespect. So you should be called Ashiva, or the inauspicious one, and not Shiva." And then Daksh took a sip of water, hurled it on Shiva, and then cursed him that may you never be a part of any yagna or sacrifice again. Gathered guests were struck dumb, but Nandi, who was Shiva's devoted servant, could not bear this insult. And so, though Shiva remained silent, Nandi took a sip of water, hurled it on Daksh, and told him, "You are so proud of your position, of your wealth, and you are always drowned in ego and keep saying meh, meh. May you now have a face of a goat soon in the near future." There was a sage Bhrigu in the audience who was on the side of Daksh. He could not take this lightly, and so he too took a sip of water and hurled a curse on Nandi and all the followers of Shiva, saying that they would be destined to roam around as vampires and ghouls, never getting any respect. They would roam with their body smeared in ashes, and so it was to be. Shiva, however, did not react, and he left the hall in silence. Seeing this, all his followers soon began leaving the hall. Bhrigu did not realize what a grave blunder he had committed. And so, as time passed, Bhrigu continued becoming more and more proud, because he was made the chief of the Prajapatis, while Shiva resided calmly and serenely in the mountains of the Himalayas. One day, Daksh decided to hold an even more huge, beautiful, wonderful, powerful yagna known as the Brihaspati Yagna. To this, he invited everybody who was pious, holy, powerful, and famous, but not his daughter Sati and nor her dear Lord Shiva. So, as people started getting ready and moved about in processions heading to Daksha's palace, Sati suddenly saw them and began wondering where everybody was set out to, for she could see in the skies that processions had begun moving ahead. And when she came to know that it was to her father's yagna, she went to Lord Shiva and began pleading with him. She said, "We must be there, for you know my father must be so busy with this preparations that he must have forgotten to invite us. And tell me, does a daughter ever need an invitation to visit her own family?" Lord Shiva smiled. He told Sati that it is true that a daughter never needs an invitation to visit her father. But remember, your father Daksha holds great hatred towards me in his heart. What good shall come of this visit to your father's place? But Sati, like any other woman who has set her heart on something, had decided to go to her father's place and she would have her way. So she begged, pleaded, cajoled, convinced, and finally showed her furious form. She said, "I will go." And so Lord Shiva smilingly agreed. Sati got ready and then, sitting on Shiva's bull Nandi, accompanied by her attendants and maids and her pet parrot, set off. There was music, there were trumpets blowing, and the procession made their way towards Daksha's palace. But on reaching there, there were no words of welcome. Nobody stood up to greet them. Nobody came out to welcome them. And Sati was puzzled. She went to her father and asked him, "Oh father, why did you forget to call us?" And Daksha just turned away. He refused to even look at his daughter. Except for her mother, nobody uttered a single word of welcome, because all the guests were scared of Daksha's wrath. Sati now began looking around and realized that in the entire hall, not a single seat was reserved for her dear Lord, the Supreme One. And so she asked her father, "Where is the seat for my Lord?" Daksha replied, "That shameless wretch who moves about with serpents coiled on his body, with ash smeared everywhere, wearing just a loincloth, I do not wish him for be to me my guest." Hearing this, Sati could control her embarrassment no more. She shut her ears and screamed out to Daksha, "You are committing a grave blunder, using such words for the mightiest of mighty, for the Lord of Lords. I do not wish to be connected to you anymore. This body reminds me that I am Daksha's putri. And so, I will give up this body this very instant, and I will not come back until I am born to a person who is devoted to my Lord." Seeing this, to the shock of all those who had gathered there, Sati closed her eyes, meditated upon the feet of Lord Shiva, and summoning the fire and air elements in her body, created a yoga agni and immolated herself. Daksha realized the stupidity of his act, but he could not do anything now. And Nandi and the other followers rushed to inform to Lord Shiva about what had transpired. Shiva was sitting calmly in meditation. When he heard the news of Sati's death, he could control his anger no longer, and taking out a lock from his matted locks, he struck it to the ground. From there emerged a huge being, the thousand-armed, three-eyed, ferocious being called Veerabhadra, with weapons in each limb. Veerabhadra prostrated before the Lord and asked him, "What is your command?" Shiva told him, "Go and destroy Daksha's yagna." And so, accompanied by all of Shiva's attendants, Veerabhadra set out. The crowd there could not imagine what had invaded them. So soon Daksha's head was cut off and offered to the very sacrificial fire that he had just begun. And all the other devatas who had stood silent when Sati was insulted soon began losing limb, hair, eyes, teeth, and had to run helter-skelter to save themselves. All of them approached Lord Brahma. And Lord Brahma realized that Shiva had to be appeased. And so he himself went to Lord Shiva to beg for forgiveness on behalf of his son. Lord Shiva, the calm and the compassionate one, immediately agreed to forgive Daksha and all the gathered devatas and rishis. And so he said, "I will forgive all this as the ignorant mischief of a child. And so the devatas will get back all their limbs and good health. As for Daksha, let me come there." And Shiva took the head of the goat and placed it on Daksha's body. Daksha came back to life, but he was a transformed person. He fell at Lord Shiva's feet and begged for forgiveness. And Shiva, of course, gladly obliged. Now, Brahmaji and Daksha and all the devatas and rishis asked Lord Shiva to complete this yagna, which he did. And at that very moment, Garuda came flying in, bringing with him Lord Vishnu on his back. Seeing Lord Vishnu, all the gathered, esteemed, venerable persons began singing hymns and praises in praise of Lord Vishnu. And Lord Vishnu explained to the audience. He said, "Only the ignorant considers Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva as three different. We are all different forms with different powers of creation, sustenance and destruction. But in essence, we are only one. The one who knows this knows the supreme truth." Hearing these divine words from the great Lord, everybody experienced bliss and folded their hands with devotion. So this then is the story of Shiva's consort Sati, who gave up her life because she could not hear anything evil about her dear one. We too ought to remember that it is as evil to listen to someone speaking ill of the Lord as much it is to speak ill oneself. Now, what happens next? Will Shiva marry again? Will Sati be reborn? To hear this, do tune in next week. And as always, share this story with your friends, ask them to subscribe to this channel, and keep tuning in week after week. Until we meet again, Hari Om!